Welcome, my dear student, in the digital learning class of mathematics. As you all know, we are in chapter number 3, that is understanding quadrilaterals. So in this chapter we did some part, and today I am going to take your definition part, that is related how to find out the diagonals. So first, what do you mean by a diagonal? That is important thing. So a diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices of a polygon. So in simple language, if you want to say, so it is a line which is joining two distinct points of any polygon. So just see the first example, it is a rectangle. Here I have drawn two lines. These are the maximum possibility to join the point. See, P and Q are not consecutive. That means consecutive means regular points. P and Q are separate from each other, so we can join them. And next is Q to S. This is also separate. Both are separate, so we can join them in this way. It is getting two diagonals. And in case of pentagon, we have five diagonals. So here, what to do, how to draw a diagonal, that is the problem. So for my students, to draw diagonals, you need to select two different points of a figure and join them in between the figure or outside the figure, so that whatever the lines you are getting, total lines, those are total diagonals. Here last one case you can see, it is a case of quadrilateral, but it is a concave quadrilateral. So in this case you can see one diagonal is M to K and one is outside the figure, that is L to N. In this way sometime you will get polygons diagonals are inside and sometime outside the figure. So next one we have regular and irregular polygons. You all studied now about polygons. Polygons means a closed figure that is having many sides. So here we have two category, one is a regular polygon, one is irregular polygon. First one is a regular polygon, that simple language if you want to say, a polygon having same side, all equal side we can say. So as for example, you can take example of square where all sides are equal, as well as equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. So such cases in which all sides are equal are coming in the category of regular polygons. And irregular polygons means different side. As a rectangle we have, in rectangle the opposite sides are equal, but if you are talking about all sides, so they are different. In case of a triangle, simple triangle if you are taking, so all sides are different. Now next category, what is the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral? So if you see quadrilateral, if you are dividing, in earlier case I have divided by the help of diagonal, so it is made up of two triangles. So for one triangle, you know, sum of one triangle is 180, sum of angles of a triangle is 180. So for two triangle it become 180 into 2, so answer become 360. So in this way you can write this one. Rest, let's take your question number 2 of exercise. How many diagonals does each of the following have? First is convex polygon, convex quadrilateral. So convex means all the angles inside a figure are less than 180. So once again you can see, here I have joined A and C and B and D. So what we can say, a convex quadrilateral has two diagonals. Here you can see AC and BD are two diagonals. So let's move toward next, that is regular hexagon. So in regular hexagon you can see, B regular word is there, that means all six sides are equal. So let's see, you can start joining like AE, A to E join, A to D you can join, BD. So in the same way as I told you, you need to join all these lines. How many maximum point you can join from one point, join them, and then you will get these all diagonal. And in case of regular hexagon you will get 9 diagonals. But in case of triangle, my dear students, there is no diagonal. You can see here, we have no choice. A and C already joined, B and C already joined, C and B is also already joined. There is no option where we can join any other line. So in case of triangle, there is no diagonal. I hope my student you are able to understand this concept of diagonals. Thank you so much.